Yes, good morning students. So today we are going to discuss about particular integral of higher order linear differential equation. In the earlier class we discussed about complementary function of higher order differential equation. As we know, the higher order linear differential equation of the form a0 d to the power of n, a1 d to the power of n minus 1 and so on, an of y equal to q of x. Okay, so here is we are taking, this is f of d of y equal to q of x form. Okay, so the complementary function, that means by taking auxiliary value f of m equal to 0, by taking roots of, depending on roots of f of m, we are discussed about complementary functions. Today we are discussing about particular integral. Okay, so the particular integral of this differential equation is 1 by f of d into q of x. Okay, so how we can find f of d? Before going to discussion of f of d, as we know, d equal to derivative d by dx, d inverse equal to 1 by d. So antiderivative, we know it is an integral of. Okay, so d square d to the power of minus 2 equal to 1 by d square equal to double integral d cube triple integral, like that. Okay, so we can calculate, suppose f of d value, this f of d value is d, then it is equal to integral of q of x dx. Suppose this f of d value is d square, then it is a double integral of dx dx. Okay, so suppose it is a d cube triple integral, like that you can consider. Okay, so the basic formula for this calculation of particular integral is, suppose f of d value is d minus a, then particular integral is pi equal to 1 by d minus a into q of x is equal to into e to the power of, you can observe this is minus a. Whenever we have minus a, take e to the power of plus a into integral of e to the power of minus a, this opposite sign, into q of x dx. Okay, clear? So 1 by d minus a into q of x equal to e to the power of minus ax into integral of e to the power of minus ax into q of x dx. Okay, suppose it is 1 by d plus a into q of x equal to, this is a plus, so you take minus opposite value, minus ax into integral of, we are taking here is minus, then you take here is ax q of x dx. Okay, so you remember these two formulas. Okay, so basic formulas for finding particular integral, 1 by d minus a q of x equal to e power ax into integral e to the power of minus ax into q of x dx, 1 by d plus a into q of x equal to e to the power of minus ax into integral of e power ax into q of x dx. Okay, so using this formula we are going to solve one problem, that is find particular integral. Okay, I am writing p dot I, instead of particular writing, I am writing p dot I. Particular integral of, okay, d square plus a square of y equal to secant ax. Okay, so this is f of d. So particular integral yp equal to 1 by d square plus a square, d square plus a square into secant ax. Okay, so you can resolve d square plus ax factors, that is d plus ai into d minus ai, okay, secant ax. Okay, again you resolve this factors into partial fraction form, 1 by d minus ai minus 1 by d plus ai. Okay, na you observe, so d plus ai, this is minus d, minus or minus plus ai by d minus ai into d plus ai. Okay, so you observe in the numerator dd get cancelled, we have 2i, so that you can multiply with 2ai. So 2ai into 1 by d minus a into 1 by d plus a into secant ax. So this is equal to 1 by 2ai into 1 by d minus ai into secant ax minus 1 by d plus ai into secant ax. So you observe it is a d minus a formula, it is a d plus a formula. Okay, so you can calculate one section, first section. Okay, so instead of, or you can calculate second section, instead of a, instead of I, you can place minus I. Okay, clear? So consider 1 by d plus ai into secant ax. This is equal to, by basic formula, it is e to the power of minus ai into integral of, okay, e to the power of ai into secant ax dx. Okay, so this is equal to e to the power of minus aix into, so this is of the form integral of, okay, e to the power of aix means e to the power of I theta form. E power I theta means cos theta plus I sin theta. So write cos theta plus I sin theta form. This is a cos, instead of theta it is ax. Cos ax plus I into sin ax into secant ax dx. Okay, write secant ax equal to 1 by cos ax. 1 by cos ax. Okay, so you can simplify. So it is equal to e to the power of minus aix into, okay, integral of cos by cos 1 plus I into sin ax by cos ax dx. Okay. So equal to e power minus aix into, okay, integral of 1 x plus I into sin, cos derivative is sin. So minus sin ax into a. So you can take minus log cos ax by a. Okay. Since here is no minus, so that I am taking minus, and here is no a, so that I am taking a here. Okay, so this is equal to e to the power of minus aix, axi, axi, I am writing x minus I by a into log cos ax. Here is, this is d plus a form. Now consider 1 by d minus ai, just you replace I by minus I, okay, na I by minus I, so equal to e to the power of a x I x plus, okay, minus I is replaced by I, so x plus I by a cos log cos ax. We are just replacing I by minus I, therefore this is minus I is replaced by I, and minus I is replaced by plus I. Okay, so this is equal to part 1 and part 2. This is equation 1, and it is equation 2, and it is equation 3. Okay, so use equation 2, 3 here. We have 1 by 2ai into d minus a, so e to the power of axi into x plus I by a log of cos ax. Okay, and the second term is e to the power of, this is second term, e to the power of minus axi into x minus I by a log of cos ax. Okay, so again you observe x common I by a log cos ax, I by a log cos ax common, so that you can take 1 by 2 ai, this is a common term, and x common term, take x as common,
e to the power of axi minus, it is e to the power of axi. And again, take I log cos ax by a as common. Then we have e to the power of axi minus, here is minus of minus of plus, it is plus e to the power of minus axi. Okay. So as we know, 1 by 2 ai into x into, this is a cos I theta minus a cos I theta minus a cos I theta. So cos theta plus I sin theta minus a cos theta minus I sin theta. Cos cos get cancelled. So only we have 2 times I sin theta. The theta is axi. So sin ax plus I log cos ax by a into, okay, this is summation. So cos theta plus I sin theta plus cos theta minus I sin theta. So second terms I sin theta get cancelled. So 2 cos theta. Okay. So 2 into cos of ax, ax. Clear? Right. Again you observe. So in the first term 2 cancelled and I cancelled. So we have x into sin ax by a plus, so in the second term ii get cancelled and 2 get cancelled again. So cos ax into log of cos ax, okay, whole by a and a square. This is the required yp. Therefore the required yp is yp equal to, yp means particular integral is equal to, okay, x into sin ax by a plus cos ax into log of cos ax whole by a square, okay, right. Use the basic formula for any f of d and q of x. Okay, suppose f of d of y equal to q of x is our differential equation. Okay, if f of d value, if q of x value, q of x equal to e to the power of ax, then yp equal to 1 by, as we know, f of d into q of x equal to 1 by, okay, f of d into, here we are taking q of x is e to the power of ax. So simply you can take instead of d equal to a. So this is equal to 1 by f of a into e to the power of ax. Okay. So here is f of a not equal to 0. F of a not equal to 0. Okay, condition 1. Suppose f of a equal to 0. What happened? If f of a equal to 0, as we know the solution, x equal to a is the solution. So x equal to a is the solution. That means f of d can be written as d minus a into a remaining factor g of d. Okay, suppose x equal to a is a solution of k repeated times. That means d minus a whole to the power k times, and g of d is the remaining term, and g of a not equal to 0. Then what happened? Yp equal, in that case yp equal to 1 by f of d into e to the power of ax equal to, okay, 1 by d minus a whole to the power of k into g of d into q of x e to the power of x, e to the power of ax. As we know, okay, as we know, this is equal to 0, because e to the power of ax, instead of d you can place a equal to 0. This is undefined value. So, and f of a value is not equal to 0. Therefore, you can take g of a that is not equal to 0, and 1 by d minus a whole to the power of k into e to the power of ax. Okay, this is equal to 1 by g of a into, okay, x power k by k factorial into e to the power of ax. This is the recurrent formula. Okay, so we have two formulas. First one is 1 by f of a into e to the power of ax when f of a not equal to 0. Suppose it is a factor of k times, then it is x power k by k factorial into e to the power of ax, and the remaining is 1 by g of a, where g of a not equal to 0. So first one is d square plus 2d plus 1 of y equal to 2 into e to the power of 3x. Okay, so solution is, okay, yp equal to 1 by d square plus 2d plus 1 into 2 times e to the power of 3x. Okay, so 2 into 1 by d square plus 2d plus 1 e power 3x. Okay, so as we know, 1 by f of d into e to the power of ax formula is, you can substitute d equal to a. Okay, so 2 times e to the power of 1 by d replaced by 3. 3 square plus 2 into 3 plus 1 into e power 3x. Okay, so 2 into 1 by 9 plus 6 plus 1 into e power 3x. Okay, so 2 by, so this is a 16 e power 3x. So e to the power of 3x by 8. Okay, second one. So yp equal to d square minus 4d plus, this is a 4, okay, plus 4 into e power 2x. Again, you observe here, this is the form of a square minus 2ab plus b square form. So that d minus 2 whole square into e to the power of 2x. Okay, so here you apply, when d equal to 2, 2 minus 2, it is 0. So f of d value is 0. Okay, f of a value is 0. So you can apply 1 by d minus a whole power k into e to the power of ax, means x power k by k factorial into e to the power of ax. Okay, so apply this formula. So we have, this is equal to, where k equal to, so d minus a, d minus 2 whole square, where k equal to 2, okay, and a equal to 2. So e to the power of x square by 2 factorial into e to the power of 2x. Again, it is x square by 2 factorial, means it is 2 into e to the power of 2x. Okay, clear. Third one. So third one is d square plus 5d plus 6. So 1 by yp equal to 1 by d square plus 5d plus 6 into e to the power of minus 2x. Okay, again you observe here, d square plus 5d plus 6 factors are 1 by d plus 3 into d plus 2. Okay, observe, d square, d into d, d square, this is 2d plus 3d, 5d, and 3 into 2, 6. Okay, and e to the power of minus 2x. Okay, so we factorize the term, this expression, in the form of d plus 2 into d plus 3. Okay, by substitution of minus 2, it becomes, so minus 2 plus 2, so it is 0. Okay, so 1 by 0 is undefined, so that this is g of d, 1 by, apply, instead of d, we are taking minus 2 plus 3 into 1 by d plus 2 into e to the power of minus 2x first. Okay, this is a non-zero, so that I am substituting d equal to minus 2 here. So plus 3 minus 2, 1. Okay, and we have 1 by d plus 2 e to the power of minus 2x. So that the multiplicity of this factor is only 1. Okay, so to the power of 1. Again, you apply same formula, 1 by d plus 2 instead of a, here is plus 2. Okay, e to the power of minus ax, x power k by k factor into e to the power of ax, okay, where a is minus 2. Again, you rewrite 1 by d minus of minus 2, okay, into e to the power of minus 2x, okay. Whenever we are substituting minus 2, it is 0. So, you take same formula, okay. So, k value is 1 and a value also minus 2. So, x power k, x power 1 by 1 factorial into e to the power of minus 2x. 1 factorial means it is nothing but 1. So, equal to x e to the power of minus 2x is the required YP. Okay. So, when f of d, f of d of y equal to q of x is our higher order differential equation. Okay. So, when, next one, q of x equal to either sin ax plus b or cos ax plus b form. Okay. So, then as usual, yp equal to particular integral equal to, so particular integral equal to yp equal to, okay, 1 by f of d into sin ax plus b or cos ax plus b. Okay. So, you can reduce f of d in terms of d square function, some g of d square. Okay. Then, sin ax plus b or cos ax plus b. So, then you can substitute d square, replace d square by minus a square. Okay. Minus a square. So, 1 by g of d square is replaced by minus a square. Okay. So, sin ax plus b or cos ax plus b. Okay. So, here the denominator term g of minus a square not equal to 0. G of minus a square not equal to 0. If g of minus a square equal to 0. Okay. So, we are considering this g of minus a square value of d equal to d square plus a square, suppose, okay, then 1 by d square plus a square into this sine, I am taking sine ax plus b, okay, so just you observe, so d square is replaced by a square, so minus a square plus a square 0, so this condition is satisfied. Okay, so it is undefined. This property is not applied here. So, in this case, you can take, okay, minus. So, integral of sine minus cos. So, that you take minus cos ax plus b by x into, okay. Minus x into cos ax plus b by 2a, okay. Or you take x by 2a into cos ax plus b. Minus x by 2a into cos ax plus b. Similarly, 1 by d square plus a square into cos ax plus b. Okay. So, cos integration sine. So, x by 2a into sin ax plus b. Okay. You remember, whenever the problem of the form 1 by d square plus a square sine. Okay. It is minus x by 2a into cos ax plus b. So, whenever we have 1 by d square plus a square cos ax plus b equal to x by 2a into sin ax plus b form. Okay. Find particular integral of d square minus 4d plus 5 of y equal to cos 4x plus 3. Okay. So, here particular integral yp equal to particular integral equal to 1 by d square minus 4d plus 5 into cos 4x plus 3. Okay. So, we know, so this is of the form, d square is replaced by minus a square, okay. So, d square is replaced by a value is 4. So, minus a square means minus 16. So, it is equal to 1 by d square, and minus 4 square minus 4d plus 5 into cos 4x plus 3, okay. So, equal to 1 by 16 minus 16 minus 4d plus 5 into cos of 4x plus 3.
Okay, equal to 1 by you simplify. So minus 16 plus 5 minus 11. Okay, so take minus as common. 4d plus 11 into cos plus 3. Okay, so as per our formula, you can reduce this function into d square function. So you can multiply and divide you can convert in terms of d square form, so that you can multiply and divide with 4d, it is a plus, so that 4d minus 11 on both sides. So minus 4d minus 11 by 4d plus 11 into 4d minus 11 into cos 4x plus 3. Okay. So it is a square, a plus b into a minus b form. So a plus b into a minus b, a minus b means a square minus b square. Then this function becomes d square form. So minus of 4d minus 11 by this is 16d square minus 11 square means 121 cos of 4x plus 3. Clear? Okay. So again, minus of 4d minus 11 by, again you reduce, d square is replaced by 4 square. Okay, minus 4 square. So 16 into d square is replaced by minus 4 square. Minus 121 into cos of 4x plus 3 equal to minus of 4d minus 11 by, okay, in the denominator it is minus 16. Okay, minus 16 into 16, 256. Minus 256 minus 121 cos of 4x plus 3. Minus of, take minus as common. It is 4d. So minus minus get cancelled. 4d plus minus 11 by 377. So 377 cos 4x plus 3. Okay, so denominator is reduced to a numerical value. Okay, in the numerator it is 4 into d means derivative and minus 11. So 4 into derivative of d by dx of cos 4x plus 3 minus 11 into cos 4x plus 3. Okay, whole by 377. Okay, so this is equal to 4 into derivative of cos minus sin and cos 4x. Okay, it is cos 4x. So 4. So 4 into 4, again it is 16. 16 minus 16 sin 4x plus 3. Okay, minus 11 cos 4x plus 3 whole by 377. Okay, is the required OIP. Next, second one. YP equal to, for the second problem, YP equal to 1 by d square plus 4 into sine 2x. Okay, so d square is replaced by minus 2. Clear? Minus 2 square plus 4 sin 2x. Okay, but minus 2 square means it is a minus 4, minus 4, 0. So 1 by 0 is undefined. So whenever we have 0, 1 by 0 is undefined. Okay, this is of the form 1 by d square plus a square into sin ax plus b form. So whenever we have d square plus a square, so d square plus a square is 2 square. Okay, so d square plus a square sin 2x. Okay, so use this formula, minus x by 2a into cos ax plus b. So minus, okay, minus x by 2a, 2 into a means it is 2, cos 2x. Okay, so it is equal to minus x cos 2x by 4. Term 1, you take it is yp 1.
Okay, next. Second term, yp2 equal to 1 by d square plus 4 into cos 2x. Here also, same problem arises. D square is replaced by minus 2 square. So, it is 0. So, same. 0. Then, the formula is x by 2a into sin 2 sin ax plus b. Okay. 1 by, it is also 1 by d square plus 2 square into cos 2x form. So, that it is also minus 2 square means 0 form. So, x by 2a, 2 into 2 cos x, x 4 into, okay, yp1 and yp2. So, both together is the yp of the problem. So, yp equal to yp1 plus yp2, okay. So, first one is minus x cos 2x by 4 plus x sin 2x by 4, okay, together. So, we have x by 4 common, okay. So, taking positive term first, sin 2x and minus cos 2x is the required particular integral.